The Grand Budapest Hotel. This film has such strong characteristics and a style that it's reinforced by each scene. The film does change in main aspects and the look from scene to scene, but the core of Wes Anderson's style still remains untouched throughout the movie, making the film one of a kind. The first style choice that stands out is the change of aspect ratio, and in order to reinforce the time period in each part of the film it's set on. In the beginning, we have a 16:9 aspect ratio, the standard using in the modern days, and then when we move to transitions to the 60s and then to the 80s, and finally to the main portion of the film, the aspect ratio goes to 4:3, which is the one used in the cinema done back in the 30s, same time period as the film is set on. This might not be noticed specifically, but it helps immerse the audience subconsciously into the narrative and to absorb visual cues. Symmetry is Anderson's big signature. In all of his films, this composition choice is very noticeable. The camera moves along with the characters, establishing a three-way axis, which is expected to cause flatness, but instead, because of such a rich set design and depth of field, these camera movements work really well, often helping create the comic effect the scene needs. For example, when Agatha is being chased down the hall by Dimitri, random background characters pop in the frame, raising the tension for her, but in a comedic way. Consistent color palette, just like the aspect ratio, helps him reinforce the time period, as well as the character's internal feelings. The film is extremely colorful overall. Not only the set, but the character's wardrobe also match with the palette, creating harmony to the scene. Except at this one black and white scene, due to what is about to happen to Monsieur Gustave. He's shot outside the terrain, which to Zero is a huge loss. Not only was he a big friend, but also his mentor. The black and white style choice reinforced his sadness and grief. The framing choices are modified along with the story, which helps unfold the narrative and the highlight differences, such as the way Monsieur Gustave and Zero frame changes along with their relationship. In the beginning, Monsieur Gustave is far above Zero and does not have any personal relationship with him, which is shown with them farther apart in the frame. Zero is always farther back on the shot, and that frame changes as they start getting closer. Both characters are shot in the same distance, or occupying the same space inside the frame. Furthermore, the film uses frame within the frame continuously throughout, which adds dimension and layers to the scene, allowing multiple actions to happen at the same time. Lighting cues not only visually pleasing, but also in sync with the emotions of the characters. For instance, when older Zero is telling the author his story, the background lighting changes, and when he finally decides to speak about Agda, a key light illuminates his face beautifully, revealing his tears, connecting the audience with his feelings for her. The Grand Budapest Hotel comes with a mix of techniques ranging from early cinema VFX, such as built sets and projections, to beautifully modern composed shots. All the mise-en-scene elements combine compose this unique movie.